Welcome back. Good afternoon. Take a look at this beautiful view here. That is not New York City. That is China. And this is Guangzhou. Let's go. Let's head to the metro now. It is a beautiful day in Guangzhou City. Look at this weather. Look at that sun. It's a real scorcher today. Oh my God, look at this. Did I just walk into the future? Facial recognition for the ticket. I haven't sat my face, but I have my phone. Watch this. Oh my Lord, just scan your phone straight in. Look at this. It is like something out of a science fiction movie. Oh my God. Look at the train. I don't feel like I'm on a train. I feel like I'm on some kind of spaceship. This design is amazing. Oh my God, look at all the screens.
This train is an express. It only stops at Xianchun.
What
its terminal
on
station
earth?
Is Xianchun.
Wow, I love the design of it. In America and in the West and in Europe, the only way to experience this kind of futuristic science fiction is to watch a movie. But in China, you can just walk around. It's not science fiction anymore. China has made it science fact. Oh my God, it's every station looks just like a spaceship. I'm lost for words. I don't know. I can't talk anymore. I don't know what to say anymore. I mean, just look at this. Just look at this. What on earth is going on? That is insane. That is just remarkable. Meanwhile, in America, it looks like this. This is just simply amazing. Who's this? Oh, we've got a little... is that the metro mascot? I mean, when you go into subway in America, before you go in, you have to say your prayers and make your last wishes and contact family members before you go in, because you don't know if you're going to come out with your life or not. It's so dangerous. But I mean, here in China, don't even think about that. Don't even have that kind of thought even. I mean, it's just uncomparable. Guangzhou metro system began operation in 1997, 26 years ago. It's been maintained, it's been improved. They've added new lines all the time, like line 18. You know, improving people's lives, giving them this convenient, affordable mode of transport. But meanwhile, in America, what did America do? I mean, look at the state of their transport system and their infrastructure. And then just look at this. I mean, need I say more? She just said on the announcement that in different cars they have different levels of AC, so you can choose which one you like according to your own preference. They've thought of everything. if you want like a little bit cooler one, go down there and it tells you which number.
if you don't want it so strong, then go to another carriage down there.
Oh my god, look at the speed that is going. 160?
160?
Even when you're just walking between the stations, they have these, the little, I don't know what you call them, the little fast walkie things.
This is not an airport. We're in a metro station, subway station. And then, you know, I'm probably gonna get some American, you know, complaining on this video, saying, oh, that's just great, but that's just in one city in China. They don't have that in all the cities. Excuse me, actually, they do. In many, many cities throughout all of China, they have a real highly developed transport system, public transport system in place. I mean, I've been to a few of them. The one in Chengdu, Shenzhen, Beijing, Shanghai, Guiyang in Guizhou. There's just so many.
I don't know if you can see that on my phone there, but it says 5G. You have 5G internet on the train and in these stations, which are underground, by the way. And so you can use internet and watch your favorite vlogger. I'm watching this guy. I don't know who he is, but he's quite funny. And he's handsome too. Guangzhou Metro has 16 lines, and line 18, I was just reading, line 18 and 22 are the fastest metro lines in all of China. And the title was previously held by line 11 in Shenzhen, so they beat that one. So this is the fastest, line 18 and 22, that is crazy. I mean, just like I was saying, it's just so convenient to use this, the metro system to commute to work, go to school, as like a tourist to zip around the city and explore everywhere you want, and it's affordable as well. You know, you can just go anywhere to the airport, to the train station, and then you can catch a high-speed train and travel all over China on the high-speed trains. I mean, China's infrastructure, it just sets you up to, if you want to travel anywhere throughout the country, do business, make money, you know, they really give their people the best chance at life. I mean, that's what you get here in China. Time to go out. Just scan my phone. Simple as that. No messing around. Like in the West, they're messing around, fumbling around with coins and notes and little tickets. You know, look how easy it is. Everything cashless, just all on your phone. It's great. And in America, you also get like a little surprise inside the ticket machine. Just come out, man. I've been having fun in there for that long. That it is now nighttime. Ooh, look at that! It's like a nice little sunset there. That's beautiful. Huh. What a beautiful ending for this video. Anyway, that is me signing off in this beautiful sunset here in Guangzhou. I will see you in the next one. Signing off.